quieres. Guess what, guys? Is the last.
Oh, my God.
No, we're back.
Yeah, but right? It's an awkward day to come back.
Then we leave.
It should have came like yesterday. Woo! When I had a cute outfit.
Okay. Yeah, it was cute. And
yeah, but
ready. Good morning, and thank you for tuning in to Live and Five Show, where we are living live.
The Science Olympics are coming up soon. More details on the way.
Did you miss your sports? Because if you did, I got more coming up for you on the way.
Hey guys, we're back. And imagine taking care of 1.2 billion Catholics. More details on this huge story on the way.
It may be raining on Easter.
Oh, what?
Yep,
I heard.
Do you need AR points really quick? Stick around, we'll be right back. I'm only 16. That means it's showtime. I ain't with her.
That means I'm on my own. Everyone's building peace. You should too.
I'm a bowler, and a jacket jacker, book basher, lock and slammer. I cause chaos.
Why is he doing this? You're gonna make me late.
Detention, referral, suspension, you name it, I got it. And on top of that, Rocco stalks me everywhere I go.
Enjoy the good times, avoid chaos like me.
Proud to be a scientist and want to have some fun competing with other 7th and 8th graders in the district, on May 18th, TESOF will participate in the district's annual STEM Olympics. The Olympics is coming up and practice will begin once spring break ends. A list of events will be posted near your science class. Choose an event and sign up with the listed teacher before spring break. Put your knowledge to the test and come have fun practicing. Then on May 18th, TESOF will bring home some medals to brag about.
The principal challenge is back. The new book is Item Number 4 by Pittacus Lore. When you read the book, take the AR quiz before April 16th. The movie day is April 19th.
Today we bring you tomorrow's music segment to send you off for spring break. Check out the review Jonathan has for us.
Hey Trojans, what's up? I'm finally back after a while of no broadcasting. And the camera misses me, so I know my pretty face is now yours. And we are better than ever, because now I'm going to bring all of those popular and new songs. However, for this week, we are bringing one last song from the past, not one last. Without further delay, here's All-Star Weekend with their single, Party Like It's Not Your Birthday.
Every clock is ticking faster, taking trips around the sun. Another year, another chapter, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Drop your calls, lose your keys before the night is gone. Get yourself out your seat. Oh, oh. Quit complaining, move your feet until the break of dawn. Cause nobody really cares about the day that you were born.
Wow, that was simply spectacular. Well, not really. That wasn't spectacular. We are gonna show you like Maroon 5 and much, much more. Remember to not stop the party. Until next time, I'm your host, Jonathan Francisco. Bye.
Turn out across the globe with Dylan. Good morning, Dylan.
Jersey, and good morning, Trojans. Pope Benedict is the first pope to resign in over 600 years. Sorry. Pope George Mario Bergoglio had taken the place of Pope Benedict XVI. He is the first pope to come from South Africa. The new pope had changed his name to Francisco, and he is the first pope who has chosen the name. He has named himself after Saint Francis of Assisi. The new pope takes the job of taking care of over 1.2 billion Catholics. That wraps up here. Time to go to Jersey La Gaia for your upcoming TEDSOFF events.
Thank you, Dylan. Looking at this week, this week is the last day for school of choice. Today is the end of third quarter, and tomorrow there's no school because it's beginning of spring break. That takes care of our schedule. Let's go to Kyla Farland, Live at 5 forecast.
Spring break. I'm so excited. So we're seeing cooler temperatures 60s through the west, not the east, and we're seeing warmer temperatures in Phoenix with 88 and can't see. In the south it's warming up as well with 80s and high 70s, and we're seeing cooler temperatures in the east, and that's also going to affect the DC trip because we're going to see cooler temps through next week. And let's go to our 5-day forecast. Okay, so we're going to see today 69, tomorrow 72, and we're most likely going to see our shower move in Saturday, early Sunday, which is Easter Sunday, where we're going to have a possible chance of rain, and that will follow through with Monday at 63 and a chance of rain. Let's go to Jefferson with our web poll. Good morning, Jefferson.
Michael with us. Good morning, Michael.
Good morning.
This week, you parted the question. What are you doing for spring break? Here's what you told us about it, Trojans.
Hey, Trojans. I'm Sierra Crandall reporting for the Live at 5 show. We went around asking students and teachers about their plans for spring break. Let's find out how they are spending their vacation. Why do you like or dislike spring break?
I like it because we get to sleep.
Me too.
I like spring break because I get to be with my friends and play Xbox all day long.
I dislike it because it's only 1 week long, like, you know. Okay.
It's fun!
We like it a lot. It's awesome.
And spring time.
No school.
I like spring break because I get to play without studying. What are you planning to do over spring break?
Sleep. Spend time with my family and do a little traveling.
Play Xbox.
Sleep, Xbox, and date with my Xbox.
Sleep and party.
Sleep and party.
Play. What will you miss the most over spring break?
Basketball.
Nothing.
Friends.
I will miss all of the bright and shiny faces of our TEDSLAW students.
I miss hanging out with my best friends.
I miss how, like, I don't know, never mind.
Friends.
Yes.
My best friend, Sierra.
How long do you think spring break should be?
3 months.
2 months.
The entire school year?
Yeah.
I think a week is good, but some schools have 2 weeks, so I'm a little jealous of them.
Oh, 6 months.
A year.
Yeah,
a year.
More like a year.
Yeah.
You're
trying
to give us 1 year school.
2 months. Spring break is a time to get away from school, your teachers, and just hang out at home. If you are an 8th grader who is going on the trip to Washington, D.C., then your plans are settled. But if you have nothing to do, then your 10-day weekend won't be very exciting. Have fun planning your spring break.
Well, whether you're going to go to the 8th grade D.C. trip or just going to hang out with your family and friends, I hope you have a great spring break.
Here are the results for the past week's web poll. 12% of you wanted to spend time with family, and none of you wanted to have vacation. 12% of you wanted to sleep, and 38% of you wanted to play Xbox or video games. About 12% of the school is going to the DC trip, and 12% of you are not sure yet, and 12% of you are just gonna do nothing at all. Our new question is, should TEDSLAW students be permitted to go off campus during lunch? We want to hear from you. Be sure to visit online at liveinfashion.com or face-to-face to vote. Send your comments to our poll at liveinfashion.com, and if it's good, read on air. So, Michael, what do you think?
I think they should, as long as, like, rockers out there, the super vibes.
Why do you think kids would want to go up to campus?
Like, get fresh air from teachers and other stuff.
Do you want to give me shouts to anyone?
Yeah, like Cody, Victor, Mar, Chris, both Christians, and yeah.
Thank you for joining us today. Now let's go to Mar with Live in 5 Sports.
Thanks, guys. So I'm back for some more sports, which is sadly the end of the week because we're going to be going back to spring break, but thank goodness I'm back. So we're going to start off with some NBA. Boston beat Cleveland 93-92. New York beat Memphis 108-101. Chicago beat Miami 101-97, ending their win streak. Los Angeles Clippers beat New Orleans 105-91. Oklahoma City beat Washington. And it looks like Los Angeles Lakers beat Minnesota 117. San Antonio beat Denver 100-99. For your NHL, the Wild beat the Coyotes 6-5. The Avalanche 4-3. And the Sharks beat the Ducks 4-0 for their fourth loss in a row. That's all for now, and let's send it off to Janiyah.
Thanks, Moran. Okay, time now for your daily 411.
Which state has a spook museum? California, Hawaii, New Jersey, or Kentucky? Take 5. New Jersey has a spook museum. Because I'm spooky, I guess. Yeah.
I think it's a spoon.
Spoon?
A spoon museum?
A spoon museum.
A spoon museum.
No
okay.
Way. It's a spoon.
Oh, that's a spoon, guys.
Okay, we just lost the show.
So,
can I do it?
So you can listen to this, yes.
Actually, please. I have a shout out for the band because they helped us. Raise enough money to get our new
studio. Oh, yeah, shout out to you guys. Thank you guys, man. You guys are awesome. Before I go, I want to give a shout out to everybody who wanted a shout out on my Facebook status because I did not have enough time.
Oh, and a shout out to Mr. M, who was an awesome coach for basketball. We will miss you.
Good job, Mr. M.
Even though we lost.
And the soccer team.
Watch today's broadcast online at 11.5show.com and follow us on Facebook, Twitter, and YouTube at 11.5show.
That's all for our amazing show. We'll see you back here after spring break.